time on her own, Chrissie Hynde. Welcome.
Thank you, that's nice.
You have your first solo album out. Incredible. I mean, it's always been The Pretenders.
Yeah.
And it's called Stockholm. First of all, thank you.
Oh, thank you. the pleasure was mine.
It's recorded in Stockholm?
Oh, it made in Stockholm, yeah, the whole thing. And I didn't intend it to be a solo album, but I couldn't convince Björn Yitlin and Jaki Olhund and the guys I worked with to leave their wives. They wouldn't leave their wives in their studios and their other bands for me. So.
Looking back on your very long career, it's been Pretenders, but many different Pretenders, because there has been very many different musicians in that band, except you have been the constant.
Well, relative to the length of a band, I mean, there have been a few. I mean, I lost two members in 1985. They both died from drug overdoses. And then I sort of kept the thing alive very much in the spirit of the music, because I really felt I didn't want to let it go out of, you know, really respect for Pete and Jimmy. I wasn't prepared to not play those songs anymore. And I guess I was emotionally, you know, a bit traumatized by that. And then I worked with a subsequent guitar player for, like, you know, 10 years in a stretch.
But so. Always men. It's a very male-dominated business, rock and roll. And it strikes me that we have too few Chrissie Hyndes.
I never really thought about it like that. I mean, you know, anyone can play music if they want. There are just more men doing rock and roll.
But why is that?
I don't know. Why are you asking me? I'm a woman doing it.
Yes, you are. You are.
I can't imagine. It's the best thing in the world to play. I mean, I can't play guitar great. I get much better musicians than me to play with me. But I can't imagine a better thing to do than to play guitar in a rock band. It's all I ever wanted. I don't know why more women don't do it. I have no idea.
Have you... When people talk about you, they talk about you
as... And you know what? Mostly guys in bands, they're kind of like girls anyway. You know?
How come?
Well, you know, they're kind of, you know... You know, the thing about rock and roll is it's quite an androgynous thing, or it's certainly that's how it always was. You know, it's the sort of little, the skinny, guys in rock bands aren't into sports necessarily. They're a little more the artistic ones in the art room, and they're more feminine.
As I was saying, people are talking about you as a very cool person, and it seems like you have a lot of self-confidence. It always did.
You know, self-confidence is a real bluff. I think most people in bands and most singers and most musicians are quite in... I don't know if insecure is the word. Confidence doesn't come into it. If you believe in the music and you have a belief system, that's what guides you. Mm-hmm. I mean, mainly we're pretty scared to get on stage. And, you know, there's a lot of... I mean, if you say to a guitar player, I don't really like the way you play that, you will never hear him play that again for the rest of his life. You know, people are very nervous about what they do, and they're very easily brought down a peg if you don't. I don't mean you need a lot of praise, but this idea that you're confident. Let me put it this way. I was better at doing this than I was at being a waitress. So I had to make a choice, you know? So, I mean, confidence is a bluff. I think a lot of artists don't have much confidence.
But you win some through the years, though.
You just have to keep getting up there and doing it. It doesn't matter if you've got confidence.
If you were to give your today 20-year-old self mm-hmm. an advice, what would that be?
I would say stop smoking right now. You know, put the cork in the bottle, and you know, I think that would be where I would start.
Reading about you, it's always the same thing comes up all the time, and it's about you being a vegetarian. And this is the big thing because you've been also an activist. Mm-hmm. And you've even been arrested for that. Mm-hmm. Is that out of self-control that you are a vegetarian, or is it did you at one point just decide that no more meat, or have you always been, or how is that?
Well, when I realized that I didn't, you know, when the word vegetarian came into my, when I became aware of the fact that you could be a vegetarian, I suppose during the hippie days and when I was about 16, 17, I just thought, well, why would I want to be part of that if I don't have to? And really, the question of meat eating, now, you know, people talk about that they're environmentalists, but you can't be an environmentalist if you're a meat eater. I mean, this is a total hypocrisy. And you actually can't be a humanitarian either when you're causing all that suffering and 64 billion animals a year killed for food that you don't need, and it's unhealthy. I mean, there is no pro argument for meat eating. So for me, it's not a discipline or self-control, it's just common sense, and I just like things to make sense in my life.
So do you divide people into meat eaters and vegetarians?
Totally. Yeah. I only see meat eaters and non-meat eaters. I don't see the rest of it. You know, the rest of it to me is all secondary.
So the meat eaters.
Uh-huh.
Are they? Would you preach to a meat eater? I mean, if we were having dinner, I eat meat? Or would you sort of?
I probably would excuse myself.
Okay. I'll make a note of it. No, but I see.
Not for any other reason other than I would find it so unappetizing. I wouldn't want to be around it. And you know, if I'd invited you for dinner, I would have real trouble paying for the meal because I don't want to pay.
No, but I could pay. That's not the
problem. Yeah, but you know, it's a deal breaker for me. You know, I don't even want to go out with you.
So you couldn't be in a relationship with a meat eater.
No.
I
mean, I have gone there because they lie when they're trying to. But yeah.
But are you like?
I mean, it's not really, for me, it's just principles. I mean, I think in my life, the thing I have to live by my principles. I don't see what the point of a life is if you're not living by your principles. And if you don't have principles, then I wonder, what have you got? I mean, really, what else is there in life? So, you know, if you have a code that you live by, then that's important to you. And you just, and I don't talk about it unless someone brings it up first,
I brought it. Yes, absolutely, I did.
Yeah, because I think if you give advice to someone and they haven't asked for it, they're going to hate you for it. So the best thing is to wait until they invite.
And I think this is so interesting because every time I meet a vegetarian and around the table, mm-hmm. and this comes up, it's like it's so provoking, you know, to the meat eaters.
Every
they
time
are
that I
always,
sit down, to,
having
I never
a million,
bring it up.
And
I
do
never
you
bring
have,
it up.
What kind of shoes do you have? What kind of, you know?
Okay, well.
Yeah, I know. I'm
sorry.
I've
heard
about
every
the shoes.
Argument, but as soon as I sit down in a restaurant and I'm just about to tuck in, the first thing I hear is someone will say, "So does that mean you don't eat fish?" And I'm like, "Oh, do we really have to talk about this now?" But if they want to talk about it, then get ready.
So what about the fish? You don't eat fish?
Well, I mean...
I don't.
I see it. To me, it's very simple. You know, a fish is just like this little guy, and he's only got this small little body. And he's trying to get away from you. I feel that if I'm in this superior position and I can dominate something and they're trying to get away, I let them go.
Are you I know Paul McCartney, when he goes on tour, there's no meat, mm-hmm. for even the roadies.
Yeah,
they won't
that's
get
good.
Meat. Would you do the same?
Yeah.
Oh. Okay.
Because I'm paying for it, and yeah. I can't pay the slaughterman. That goes against my principles. I can't do it. I mean, I've been on a lot of tours, and you'll find that, you know, most people say, oh, this is good, I like this. They just haven't tried it. And I think men have a reputation of being courageous, and you'll find that usually men aren't very confrontational and they don't want to you know, really stir it up. Men are quite, like, a man will never say to another guy, turn it down. I've never met a man in a band who will tell another man to turn down. Mm-hmm. That's why it gets so loud, because everyone is cranking it up so they can hear themselves. Whereas I walk in, I go, can you guys turn down? They go, yeah. You know, but men can't do that. They can't say it to each other. I don't know why.
They wouldn't be confrontational with the food?
No, but they will say, oh, I prefer this. They'll say it, you know, but you have to kind of lead them to it like a dumb animal, and then they'll go for it.
I'm just curious.
I didn't know I was funny.
No, yeah. Yeah, you were. I was just thinking of the next question, because I find this very interesting, because I eat meat from time to time.
I was starting to figure that out.
Yeah, I had to admit it, and because I might eat something afterwards. but the thing is that I find it might be a difference between taking a life from an animal and taking a life of the animal, killing an animal. Like, don't you find it important how they treat animals?
Of course.
While they're alive.
Absolutely.
If you shoot a wild animal, it had a fantastic life.
Who are you to shoot it?
I'm the hungry man.
You know.
From the caveman, you know?
Oh, come on. Come on. We have supermarkets. I mean, that's just, you know, that's a nonsensical line of, you know, don't even go there. Nobody needs to kill animals.
Perhaps not.
However, I'm not a pacifist necessarily. And if you were trying to kill me, I would defend myself. So I do think there's always a case for killing. Absolutely.
I would never try to kill you.
You don't know yet.
I'm not that hungry.
We're just getting started here. I mean, the thing about, you know, everything that lives, lives off of something else that lives. Everything. Everything in creation. And it's just, I think it's your responsibility as a human being to decide where... How much mercy can you show while you're alive? Because one day you're going to be asking for mercy, and how much did you give? And I think that's something you should be thinking about every day of your life.
Final word from you. Thank you so much.
You fix your makeup just so. Guess you don't know your beauty.